We have come up to one function here, one of the methods, index methods. But I will start from the beginning and quickly I will explain a few things, and then in more detail I will continue from where I have been left yesterday. Let's open one of the programs here. And one of them. Okay. In order to create a list contains many items. In order to create a list, we can use either a open and close square bracket, or we can use LST2, let's say equal to. We can use the list function call with no argument. These two lines will create empty list. Or we can create a list which has some elements in it. LST3 is equal to between square brackets. I just put here values 34, 6, blah, blah, etc. Something, okay? We can use one of these methods. So the first two creates empty list. The third one create a list with some items in the list. How can I access elements in a list? We access elements in a list by using indexes. For example, if I want to access this 72, I have to use its index. And the indexes start with 0. So the first item has index 0, the second item or element has index 1, the next element has index 2. So if I say, for example, print LST3 and with index 2, it will print 72. 34 is at index 0, 6 is at index 1, sorry, and 72 has index 2. So if I run this, I will see 72 on my output. I can access since the indexes start from zero, it will go, the index of the last item will be equal to the number of elements in the list minus one. How do I get number of elements in a list? If I write, if I print len, using len, LST3, we get the length of a list. It is 5. We have 5 elements in the list. Let's put a few more elements. 4, 40, 82, whatever, 18, etc. If I run this, now there are 8 elements in the list. Okay, I see 8 here. So now we learned the first function, which is related with lists. There are few more functions. Before going further, I will just show you some other functions. If I have a list which contains numbers, then I can find the sum of all numbers by using the sum function. Print, for example, sum of LST3. Let's make this LST1, this is LST2, and this is LST, so that I will not type 3 every time. Now, we will see that the sum of all these numbers in LST is 327. What is the maximum and what is the minimum? But we can get the maximum and minimum by using the max and min functions.
So sum is a built-in function in Python?
Yes, yes, sum is a built-in function in Python. When we use sum and as argument, we use a list, it will give us the sum of all numbers in a list. Or if we use max and min are also two built-in functions in Python, and they give us the maximum and minimum. Let's put here sum is equal to comma, And let's put here maximum is equal to comma. Can you close your microphone, please? Now let's run this program again, and we will see that the result of the sum function, result of the max function, and the result of the min function are here, are printed here. So we can, by using the len function, which is a built-in function in Python, we get the number of elements in a list, and sum returns us the number of the sum of all values in a list. If there are strings, of course, we will get some error. Okay, we can have a list which contains numbers and strings. 7.2, for example, here, a float number, a string, an integer numbers, etc. When we run this, we will have an error in sum because this cannot be added to the other ones. Okay, so have a string inside a list, we cannot use sum. All have to be numbers. Let's put here 24, and then it will run correctly. Now this is about indexing. Yeah, we have seen indexing, and this indexing list two. About indexing, I will show you a few more things. I want to access the elements from the end of the list. So the first element has index 0, the second element has index 1, etc. But when I want to get the last one, there is a easy way of getting it. Let's copy this and when I use minus 1, it is the last element. It indexes the last element. So the index of the last element is either minus 1, or I can print the last element like this. Here I will say len of LST. Len of LST. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 elements here. Yeah, there are 9 elements. So len LST will give me number 9. But since the indexes start from 0, in this case, the last element will be index 8. So it is length minus 1, okay? And let's see what will be the output, 21 and 21. This is the index of the last item, but also we can use minus 1 to index the last item as well. So what is the element before the last one? Before the last one is naturally minus 2, isn't it? Last one is this one with minus 1. Before the last one is minus 2. So if I use minus 2, it is the element before the last one. 2 before the last one, it is 82. So in this case, I will use minus 3. This is 2 elements before the last one. Okay. That's about indexing. Okay, I want to add new elements to this list. Okay. In order to add new elements, we use the append method. We use a method called append method. We say lst.append, and we put inside parentheses a new value, a new item. Let's put here, for example, 55. And then let's print LST once more. Let's print LST here, print LST. And let's take the same, and let's print after the append, okay? Here is our list. After append, we have 55 added to the end. Okay. So in order to add new elements, we use the append method. What can we do to change an element? Assume that I want to change, for example, this 54 to something else. So in this case, in order to change an element, I have to use indexing. What is the index of this 54? 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, this is the element which has index 3. What I can do then here, I will say LST with index 3. Instead of 54, I want to put 60, for example. Then put 60 to element with index 3. The meaning of this statement on line 15 is put assign 60 to element with index 3. And if we print the list once more, we will see the difference that, and then we will see that it is not 54 anymore. It will become 60. 54 became 60. The rest is not changed, of course. Is this clear? Append to the end. It appends one element to the end. Change an element through indexing. We can change an element in a list. We cannot do to this same thing with strings. Strings are immutable. You cannot change. You can access a character in a string by using indexing, but you cannot change it. Okay. So you cannot use indexing on the left-hand side of equal operator for strings. But for lists, we can do that. And in lists, we can just use indexing of an element, of an array, of a list, and then through assignment, we can change its value. How can we delete? We have seen how we can append to the end. We have seen how to modify an element. How can we delete it? Assume that I want to delete this 60, which is element with index 3, or this 7.2, which is not an integer. I want to delete this one. What is the index of it? It is 0, 1, 2. The index of this 7.2 is 2. How can I delete it? We have a special construct called del. Delete LST with index 2. Okay. This will delete the element which has index 2 in the list LST. And if we print LST once more, we will see that 7.2 is deleted. Therefore, all the other elements have shifted minus one indexes. So there is no empty place inside the list. This 60 had index 3, but now since the index 2 is deleted, the index of the 60 in the list after the deletion is 2. This becomes index 3, index 4, index 5, etc. We have seen how to append to the end of a list. How can I insert an element here? Assume that I want to insert between 40 and 80 something, or instead of to the place of 82, I want to insert something so that 82 and the rest will move one position further. So what is the index of 82? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, to the fifth position, fifth index, I want to insert something. How do I do it? I just say lst.append. Insert. Insert. I'm giving Java courses, and in Java there are array lists, and in array lists you use some other method. You use the same method to add to the end and to the inside. So I've done it wrong. Insert. We first give the index. At index position 5, I want to insert what, for example, let's say 77. Okay. I want to insert 77 to the position where 82 was before, to the fifth index position. So 82, 18, 21, 55, these elements will move one element to the side, to the right side. Their indexes will increase by one. let's print this again here. We see that here 77 is inserted, and all the elements at and after the index position 5 have shifted one position forward. Is this clear? Appends to the end, insert adds a new element to a given index position in a list. So these two are used, append and insert are used to add new elements to a list. So that's why I will put this next to that one. Add to the end, add inside, change an element, delete an element. Now let's continue with extend. We can also add another list to a list. Okay, so we will use extend. It will add to the end of the list. Assume that we have another list, LST2. Here we had LST2 empty, but I will put some elements now here. LST2 will be equal to, let's put here some numbers. 11, 22, 33. Okay, that's enough. I want to add these elements to the end of LST. So what I do, I say LST.extend. I use the extend method. Extend with LST2. So all elements of LST2 will be appended to the end of LST. And if we print LST once more, we will see that 11, 12, 22, 33 are appended to the end of our list. Count. Let's change some of the values and have duplicate values somewhere here. Assume that we have here 60. So when we run this, we have 160 here and another 60 here. Okay. We have 260. This is possible. We can have the same values more than once in a list. Assume that in a list we keep the grades of students taking CS 101. So there may be many students who got 60. There may be many students who got 77, for example. Okay. So if I keep the grades, the quiz one grades or midterm grades of CS 101 students in a list, here I will have many occurrences of the same values. Now, I want to find the how many times some value occurs in the list. Here we have a method called count. Now I will put it into n. N is equal to count 60. Now what count? Of course, we have to write lst.count. It will count 60 inside the LST list. I will get, of course, I didn't print it. Let's print it. Let's directly print it instead of assigning to a variable and print that variable. Let's print that. And we see that the result is counts the number of occurrences of a given value in a list. We have seen insert, extend, count. Now we have finished what I had explained yesterday. Almost there is one or two. Oh, we have plus and minus. We haven't seen. I will explain this as well once more. About the operator count. Let's see the operators. Here. Let's again create, we have our LST, let's have ls1 new lists. I will create new lists which are smaller lists so that I can do some operations with them. ls2 is equal to, and here let's put some strings. Now this time, in this example, I will use some strings. Okay.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Can we make the user input by himself the values in the list?
Yeah, you can read from keyboard and put into a list. Do you mean this?
Like we make, like, for example, okay. I don't know, input from the user. He will input by himself.
Okay, I will do that now. For J in range, let's say foot four, so that the loop will repeat four times, and LS2 let's say n is equal to, x is equal to input, enter anything. And what I will do, I will say ls2.append x. You mean something like that, okay? We input something from the keyboard, and we assign that, we append that thing to the end of a list.
Yeah.
And enter anything. I enter something, some other thing. And let's print the LS1 and LS2. Print LS1, LS2. Of course, it will ask me again. Here is my string, is my list, which is made of data entered from keyboard, okay? Now, let's assume that we have this list, copy here, and I will just directly assign it to here. I don't want to spend time inputting this every time I run the program. I'm looking for a way of making these comments.
Like, you can just type control and question mark.
Control question mark. Okay, let's try it. Oh, it didn't work.
Like, this works in PyCharm.
Okay, there is something here, but I don't find it right now. Edit, and if I choose a few lines, it would be nice to have in source desire reaptech races to Google comment. Yeah, that's all. Okay, now I have my list two and list one and list two, LS1 and LS2. Now I can do some concatenation operations with lists as well. What I can do, I can have, for example, LS3 is equal to LS1 plus LS2. What will happen? It will take all the elements of LS1, and it will take all the elements of LS2. It will create a new list which contains everything, okay? The elements of LS2 will be added to a new list after the elements of LS1. So if we print LS3, then we will see that here is our LS1 and here is our LS2. We have printed them on one print statement, and here we have both of them put together and assigned to LS3. What else can we have? We can have a multiplication, plus adds them together. We can have again, for example, LS1, okay? Get the elements of LS1, then add to these elements of LS2, and then append again back elements of LS1. So we can have this kind of operation between lists.
Excuse me?
Yes.
If you make like LS3 equal LS1 plus LS2 plus LS3, will it work?
Tell again.
Like rather than putting LS1, the last one, we put LS3. Will it work?
Here LS3?
Yeah.
LS3 doesn't exist yet, okay? We don't have any LS3 up to this point.
Uh-huh. Okay.
If it was, yes, it would work. Let's do it like this. LS1 is equal to something like that. It will work, of course. You mean this?
Yeah, for example,
it will work, no problem.
Yeah.
It will take the original values of LS2, it will add to these dual elements of LS1, it will create a new list, and that list will be assigned to LS1. So LS1 will change after that, okay? So let's leave it as LS3 with LS1 and 2. Plus LS1 again. Let's leave it like that. Now, another operator is the asterisk operator. Asterisk operator produces a new list that consists of repeated elements of a multiplied list. Here I have in my LS1, I have Abba Dede Haha. Okay. And what I can have, for example, LS4. Oops, let's make this here. LS4 is equal to the LS1, and all elements of LS1 are repeated, for example, 3 times. So since there were 3 elements in LS1, how many elements will be in LS4? 9 elements. And these elements will be repeated 3 times. But they will be repeated like that. Abba dede haha, and then again abba dede haha, abba dede haha. Okay. And if we print this LS4, we will see that we have this Abba Dede Haha, and again Abba Dede Haha. Okay, 3 times they are repeated. What we can have, one more thing about this, assume that I have, let's remove some of them, okay? Let's make this only 2 elements, and let's make this only 3 elements. Here I will have LS5 is equal to LS2 plus 2 times LS1. Guess what will be our list. Let's put here A1, B2, C3 to tell it easier. Print LS5. What is the content of LS5? We have here an expression about lists. The expression has LS2 plus 2 multiplied by LS1. Again, the multiplication or the asterisk operator has precedence over the plus operator. So what will happen? It will create a list in which the elements of LS1 are repeated twice. So Abba Dede, Abba Dede. They are repeated twice. And then those elements are appended to the end of LS2, but in a new list. The LS2 elements are followed by twice the LS1 elements. So when we run this, we will have A1, B2, C3, which is LS2, and the elements of LS1 are repeated twice, Abba Dede, Abba Dede. OK? Okay. So you can have this kind of expressions. One more operator plus there is, we have seen plus operator, asterisk operator. There is one more operator, which is in operator, to check if a value exists in a list or not. Let's take this list once more. Let's this one. Let's take this here and put it here. I want to check if a given value exists inside this list or not. So for this purpose, we can use if. For example, is there 20 in LST? In operator checks an expression with in operator returns either a true either true or false. If the first argument in operator exists in the second argument, which is a list, then it returns true. If the first operand doesn't exist in the second one, it returns false. If it exists, it returns true. So what I can do, let's say print exists in LST. Okay, let's write something like this. We will see that it will not print anything. But now instead of 20, let's put here 40. If I run it, I will see that 40 exists in LST is printed. Okay, let's put here else, and let's copy this here. Does not exist in LST, in list, in the subject list. If we run this, it will print 40. If I change this to 20, I have to modify three places, of course. In this example, it will say 20 does not exist in list. So what can be a better approach? And 20, put here n, and put here n, comma, and remove these characters, and n, comma, this. Okay, now 20 doesn't exist in the list, is printed, but now 20 is stored in a variable n. If the value inside n exists in list, this n in list LST returns true. If it does not exist, it returns false. So we have seen plus, minus, and in operators, the list operators in Python. We have seen del, we have seen indexing. Okay. Anyway, let's continue with this. Now we can look to the methods. We have seen append, insert, extend, count, index method. We have been stopped here yesterday. Now, what is in the index method do? Index method returns the index of the first occurrence of a value inside the list. So here, we know that 40 exists in the list, okay? Let's try this for 40. So what we can do, k is equal to lst.index and 40. What we will get, not 49, 40, we will get the index of the first occurrence. If there were 40 more than once, okay, there is 140 here, another 40 here. What will this lst.index 40 will give us? Give us the index of the first occurrence, not the others. And what is the index of this one? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we will, if I print k, I will get 5 printed, as we see here. Okay. But this is a danger. If I want to try to find the index of 20, then my program will crash. There is an error. So in order to use the index method, it is better to check that the existence of that value with in. Okay, so it is better to have, for example, assume that we have n is equal to 20, for example, and I want to find the index of 20, the first occurrence of 20 inside. So what I do, I first say if n in LST, I check if it exists. If it exists, then I have this statement, okay? Of course, with n. It doesn't print anything because n 20 doesn't exist in the list. But if I have, for example, here 40, now I have 5 printed, which is here, which is printed here. So before using index, it is better to check if the value in the index method exists in the list with in construct. Assume that I want to replace 40, the first 40 by 42. Okay, so what I will do, I will check if 40 exists first of all. If it exists, I will get the index, and here I will use, I will change this to LST to print the list once more. But here, since I have the index of the first occurrence of 40, I can change it. How do I change it? Do you remember? LST K. I use the indexing equal to 42. Okay. Here I got the index put into K. Now K has the index of the first occurrence of 40 in the list, because LST index returns the first occurrence of the given value in the list. And then using that index value, I change that element. And when I print it, it will print 42 instead of 40. That's what I will do. Before this, I will just print that. And let's also copy here. That's one once more here, that we have all in the same place. Okay, it was 40 and now it is changed to 42. But I don't want to only change the first occurrence of 40 to 42, but all occurrences of 40 to 42. There is another one here, and there could be somewhere else as well. What I do now, if I change if to while, what will happen? It comes here. We have a list. Let's put another 40 here, okay? Let's have a 40 here. What will happen? N in list will be true because 40 exists in the list, okay? So it will go in the first time in the while loop, in the first iteration of the while loop, the k equal LST index 40 will give me the index value of the first occurrence of the 40. I replace it with 42. So this 40 will become 42. And since this is a while loop, it will come back and check the condition again. Is there another 40? And is there any 40 in the list? Now this 40 became 42, but there is another 40 here. So for the second 40, this in LST will be true. It will come here, k LST index n will give me the index of the second 40, because the first 40 is changed to 42. So the first in the new variation of the list, the first 40 is here in the middle. So we get its index, we change this 40 to 42, come back to the beginning of the while loop. Is there any 40 in the list? Yes, there is one 40 in the list. Here we get its index, we change that element to 42. Now all elements are of the all three 40s are replaced with 42. So when we come back, n in 40 in LST will be false because there is no more 40 in the list. It will exit. And when we print this, we'll see that the first 40 is changed to 42, the second 40 is changed to 42, the third 40 is changed to 42. So we used a while loop to check each time, every time, if some value exists in the list, then if it exists, we get its index and we change it to another value. Here, k is equal to LST index. So what I can do, instead of assigning LST index n to k and use it, I can just take this, put it instead of k, and remove these lines. It is the outcome will be exactly the same, okay? Why do it twice? Here I have LST index n, get the index of the first occurrence of n, and using indexing ls with the number, with the index here inside, change the element to 42, okay? This may be, at the beginning, a little bit more confusing to you, but yeah, the other one is also, this is as exactly as valid as the previous one, which was like that, okay? Because we assign this, okay? We only assign once and use once. So instead of doing this, it is better to take this and put instead of k and get rid of the line 54 here in this program. Let's continue index. We have other variations of index. Index starting from a given position. We can have, for example, search the first, give us the first, the index of the first occurrence of 40 after index 5, for example, okay? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Starting from 5 and more, or from, four, let's say, 4. If I use, for example, here, K2 is equal to, of course, there are no more 40s at this point. So what I will do, it somewhere here. K2,
excuse me.
Yes.
Can't we say while LST.index and do this stuff rather than putting n in this?
Yeah, here what we do is we replace all occurrences of 40 with 42, okay?
Yeah.
So we don't know. There may be 40 zero times, one time, two time, 10 time, 20 time. I don't know at all. So first of all, I have to use while in this case. Second.
Yeah. I understand that. But yeah. What I mean, like instead of saying while n in LST, k equal LST.index, we can say like just while LST.index between parentheses n. And do LST equal K, equal 42.
You mean, okay, let's copy this and try to do it what you say, Control C. You say put this in the while?
Yeah.
But this and in LST returns either true or false, okay? So while loop continues as long as the condition here is true. But this doesn't return either true or false. For while loop, I have to have some expression, some logical expression, which either becomes true or false. If it is true, the while loop repeats. If it is false, it doesn't repeat. But this gives me either some error message if n doesn't exist in the list or a number 5, 3, 4, 0, etc. Okay, so I don't see any meaning to that. Okay. I have to check if it exists. If it exists, then I can get the index. If n doesn't exist, I cannot get the index. Okay, so when I do this, I can. What will I write after that? Will I have to repeat this again? I don't know. Okay, do you understand what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay, so
I thought that this LSC.index between n, it means like if there is or there is not.
No. This returns a number. Okay. The first time, the 40 is at index 2. Okay. 34 is at index 0, 6 is at index 1, and 40 is at index 2. So LSD index n returns 2. Okay. This gives me 2. So what I do, LSD 2, the second element, is replaced with 42. This gives me an index value. LSD.index gives me, returns me an index value. So here I cannot do that.
Okay.
So what I was doing, index, what I would do, I forgot. What I was telling before that.
Hocam galiba belli bir sayıdan sonrakileri değiştirmek için.
Now I want to check that normally LSD index n returns the first occurrence, but I'm not interested in the first occurrence, but with some other occurrence starting from some middle part of the list, for example, assume that I want to check starting from index 4. 34 is index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here the index 4. At index 4 we have this element. Okay, I want to check from that position on. So what I write find the index of 40 starting from index 4. Okay, the meaning of this, here at 4 we have 24, at 5 we have 40. So this time we will get 5. But here the first time we will get 2. Okay, if I have, for example, let's put again it here. K1 with only 40, with nothing, it will give me 2, because the first occurrence of 40 is at position 2, index 2. The next one is at index 5, 6, 7. The next one is index 8. Okay, so 44, after 4, we will get. It is at index 5, or if after 3 it is at index 5. Okay, we can have a second argument which says that find the index of that element starting from that index position. It is not quite useful. Let's go here. I will skip that one. It is not too useful at all. POP, I will continue with POP.
Professor, just a question.
Yes.
What if we want to add two lists, but we want to exclude a number?
What do you mean, include two lists? And here we have an example here where we appended a list, extend list with another list. And ignore some values here, you mean?
We want to calculate the numbers inside the list, but we want to exclude a certain number.
What you can do, for example, I want to find how many numbers are there in a list which are not equal to a given number. You mean that?
No, I mean like, for example, for the list, we want to add all the numbers, like 34 plus 6 plus 7.2, etc. But we want to exclude a certain number in the list, like we don't want to add it.
You don't want to add 54, for example?
Yes.
From the list? What you can do is this, in this case. You can find the sum. And from sum, you can subtract the number of 54s multiplied by 54. Okay, so what you can do is something like that. SS is equal to sum of LSD minus LSD dot count 54. There may be many 54s. Okay, let's put here another 54. 54. But I want to exclude 54s from the sum. I want to exclude this one and this one. This is what you say?
Yes, but I meant if we didn't know the number, like if it was a variable.
No problem. Let's go here. Assume that we have n is equal to 54. Put n here and n here. LS count n will count the number of times n occurs in the list. Multiply by it. It is the sum of all those elements. And from the overall sum of the list, I subtract that value. Then I have the sum of the numbers in the list except all 54s, okay? Or whatever. Is it okay?
Okay, thank you.
Did you understand the solution?
Yes, I know this solution, but I meant something else.
What?
Like, if the user is inputting multiple numbers, and for example, we want to exclude every numbers ending with 2, for example.
Yeah, what we can do, you can take the original list, you can remove all the numbers entered by the user from the list, get a new list, and you can get the sum of that list, okay? Instead of doing in one or two steps, you can do in 3, 4, 5 steps or whatever, but you have to work on it. Now I will do something about that. Assume that here I checked while and in list, and we modified the list, okay? But now I will do something else. I will delete all 40s, for example. Instead of change them to 42s, I want to remove all of them. I will copy this here. Let's assume that now n is equal to 42. Now, after the first operation, all 40s are replaced with 42. Assume that now I want to remove all 42. What I do is just this, okay? If n is in the list, get its index and delete that element, okay? Here we get the index of the first occurrence of that number in the list, delete that element. Then we check again, is there any other n in the list? If there is an element in the list, if there is an element which contains the value of n in the list, then n in LST will return true. We will go in, we will get the index of the first occurrence of n in the list, and we will delete that as well. So this loop will delete all occurrences of n from the list, okay? Let's even put here print and delete all occurrences of a value from list. Do you understand now? Do you understand this one? Delete all occurrences of, no, 40s are replaced to 42, and I removed all 42. This 42 is deleted. I have 54, 20, blah, blah. This 42 is also deleted. I have 82, 54, blah, blah. This is also deleted. So here I have deleted all occurrences. And what I will do, I will just take this and put it here. Modify. Okay, here all 40s are modified, and here all 42s are deleted. Is it okay? If I want to find a value, the index of a value in the list, I use LST index. And I can use LST index for this kind of problems, to solve this kind of problems, to modify all all occurrences of a value, or to delete, for example, all occurrences of a value. Assume that I will not put 40, but I will add 10 to it. What I will do, I will write here, for example, n plus 10 because I'm looking for n, okay? So the list k is equal to n. So in other way, like I said, plus equal 10. Add 10 to that element. All occurrences of 40 are increased by 10. In this example, we are increasing all occurrences of 40 with 10. So here it is better to put here, for example, 50 if I want them to be deleted. Now 40 is increased by 10. 40 is increased by 10. Now I will do one more thing about changing elements. I want to add 10 to all values, for example, between 20 and 50, okay? All elements which are between 20 and 50 will be increased by 10. How can I do this? Let's solve this problem and finish our lecture of today. Increase by 10 all values in, for example, 20.40 range, both inclusive, of course. I will write a program segment for that, and I will finish the lecture. Increase by 10 all elements which have range 20 to 40. Okay, both inclusive. How can I do that? Now, here I cannot use in, etc. It's not only one value, it is many values. So there are different values. And 20 may exist, 21 may not exist, etc., etc. So I have to visit all the elements of the list. How do I do it? I use a for loop. I will use j for index in range len of LST, okay? And here, before doing this, again, let's assign those elements here. Let's put those elements here so that I can do this properly. This list, we will change all values between 20 and 40. So 34 will be increased, 40 will be increased, 24 will be increased, 40 will be increased, 18 is outside the range, 40 will be increased again, okay? The rest will be unchanged. And what I will do now, with this loop, I have range len LST. What is len? The number of elements in the array list, in the list. Range produces values from 0 to 1 less than this. So it will produce, this will produce the indexes for LST, okay? This produces indexes for LST in J. So what I do, I will just have an if statement. If LST J, that element, is greater or equal to 20, and I'll just copy this, it is less than or equal to 40, then it is in this range. It is one of the elements that should be increased by 10. If this is the case, then what I will do, LST J plus equal 10. And let's print the list again here. I print the list. Here I have them. But I will print the list also just before it and after it. Before, it was this list. 34 is between 20 and 40 increased. 6 is not. 40 is increased by 10, 54 is knot, 24 is increased, 40 is increased, 82 knots, 54 knot, 18 knot, 40 is increased, and 60 is not increased, okay? So here, I'm visiting all the elements of the array list by using this for loop. I use a variable for index, and here I use range, len, and the name of the list, okay? If you write such a for loop, it will generate in the for loop variable, which is j here, all possible index values. And now I can use the elements by indexing. Get the jth element of that, compare with 20, if it is greater or 20 and less or equal to 50, then the condition is satisfied. It is in this, the number of the element of the list is in this range, then change it. Otherwise, don't change it, okay? So with this loop, we will be changing all elements of the list between 20 and 40 and increase them by 10, okay? Is this understood? Is this example understood? It is important then that you understand this one, because this is not difficult, but this is medium, let's say, and probably you will have in second quiz and in the final questions similar to these ones, okay? We will say, write a Python program that increases by 10 all values in blah blah range. Maybe we can even say between N1 and N2, okay? Both inclusive. So we will, here we will have, instead of 20, we will have N1 and N2. Of course, you don't need to initialize N1 and N2. We will say that in a real program, I have to define N1 and N2. N1, N2 is equal to some values, let's say 23, between 23 and 42, for example. Okay. But in the question, we will say that assume that N1 and N2 contains numbers and N1 is less than N2, write a Python program that increases all values in a list, or increase by 10 all values in a list for the numbers between N1 and N2, both inclusive. Then you will only write those three lines, okay? If there is a question like that, it will mean that we are only interested in these three lines. You will only write those three lines, not more, okay? And we can also say, yes.
Sorry, can you write the question as a comment? Because
let's write the question as a comment. Does three single quotations use the comment? Yeah. Here I will write the comment.
But this will be like a string.
Assume that N, N1, and N2 contains numbers. Okay. And then write a Python program that increases by n all elements of list LST that are between all elements of, let's put here this, between N1 and N2, both inclusive. Question will be like this, okay? Assume that N1 and N2, all three variables contain some numbers. Write a program that increases by N, that variable, all elements of a list LST that are between N1 and N2. So here we will not increase by 10, but by N, okay? So the answer will be these three lines to this. It doesn't say print. It doesn't do, so you don't need to write any print here, okay? It just says write a program that increases some elements by n in the list. So this is what you will do. If it doesn't say print, you shouldn't write any print statement in your in the answer. Is this clear now?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, you are welcome. We are finishing our lecture now. Let's put here n as well, so that when you when I will run this, increase by 7. Okay. If there is no there are no questions, then we can finish our lecture.